afternoon, students. Now we will discuss chapter 3. Okay, geography chapter 3. Natural vegetations and wildlife resources. This one. Okay, it's in page number 143. Okay, in our previous chapters, we have discussed about the land use patterns, the importance of land, soil, and water in our life. Today, we will discuss about the natural vegetations and wildlife resources. Okay, so vegetations, what is vegetations actually? Okay, vegetations, it may be plants, it may be shrubs, bushes. These are the vegetations. Okay, and natural vegetations mainly grouped into four major types. Vegetations grouped into four types. Okay, vegetation, four different types. Okay, the first one, that is forest. Okay, forest, then grassland. Okay, grassland. Then after that, shrubs or scrubs, okay, and the last one, that is the tundra vegetation. Okay, so vegetations are grouped under these four heads. Okay, forest, first one is forest, second one is grassland, then scrubs, then the tundra. It is here also in your book. Okay, so forest, these are present in the areas where heavy rainfall occurs mainly. Okay, so present in areas that they have very heavy rainfall. So these are the forests. We know that the trails, but there are types of forests. We will discuss later in the same chapter. Grasslands are mainly found in the areas which experience the moderate rainfall. Yes, neither too hot nor too cold. Now we will discuss about chapter 3, okay, natural vegetations and wildlife resources, this one. Okay, in earlier chapters we have studied that land uses of land, yes, land use patterns, soils and water, the importance of these three elements in our basic lives. Today we will discuss about natural vegetations and wildlife resources of India. Okay, so vegetations mainly, that is categorized under four heads. Okay, forest, grassland, scrubs and tundra. These are the vegetation types of vegetations we found in different belt in India or even in the world. Forest, these are the areas where the rainfall, where we get the heavy amount of rainfall. Okay, and the area which have abundant water supply. So these areas, that is considered as forest. Next is grassland. Grasslands are mainly found in the areas which experience moderate type of rainfall, moderate rainfall, not too high, not too less amount of rainfall. Okay, and mainly the grass in the grassland, the plants that grows in the grassland, these are short and stunted. Okay, stunted species. Then next one, that is the scrubs. Scrubs are the plants specially found in the desert areas, means dry areas, arid areas, like thorny scrubs, small bushes. These are the scrubs. And the last one, that is the tundra, that is found in the tundra areas, means that is in the cold areas, okay, polar areas. So tundra type of vegetation is mainly found in the tundra regions, that is in the polar, where there is a very chilly, severe climate. Okay, now the types of forest. Okay, forests are mainly divided, categorized into two heads, that is evergreen forest and the deciduous forest. It is here also, it is also given in your book. Okay, this one. So there are two types of forest. One is evergreen forest. From the term only we can define, yes, evergreen, always green. So they do not shed their leaves, they do not shed their leaves, and the greenery is always covered over, the green cover of leaves throughout the year we can see in this type of forest, evergreen forest. Okay, and it is mainly found in the areas where rainfall exceeds 140 centimeter. Okay, so
These are some of the characteristic features of the evergreen forest. Whereas in other site, deciduous forest, these are the types of forest where the plants often shed their leaves. These are also the difference between, okay, and almost look barren because the trees or the plant, they shed their leaves. And this type of forests are mainly found in the areas where rainfall is from 75 to 140 centimeters. Okay, and this type of rainfall is again categorized into two heads: tropical forest and temperate. Okay, tropical and temperate. Okay, temperate forest means these two are the types of deciduous forest: tropical deciduous forest and temperate deciduous. So the deciduous trees or the deciduous forests which are found in the tropical belt are called the tropical deciduous forest, and the areas where the deciduous forests are found in the temperate belt, these are called the temperate deciduous forest. Okay, and tropical forests, these are mainly found in South Africa, Australia. Okay, and temperate forests are found in the North Central European areas, Asia, some parts of Asia and United States, and even that this evergreen forests are found in the Western Ghat and the Himalayan belt. Okay, so these are the two important types of forest: evergreen forest, deciduous forest. Evergreen forests which do not shed their leaves. Okay, evergreen. Okay, it is green throughout the year, and deciduous forest which shed their leaves, so it looks almost barren. And these type of forests are divided into two heads: tropical and temperate forest. Okay, now the importance of forest. Forest is very important for us that we know, because it is one of the important resources. Okay, so the forests are found in the areas where we have a very high amount of rainfall. Okay, and the functions of this forest are again categorized into three heads: productive functions, protective functions, and the regulating functions. Three functions are given. Okay, number one, that is the productive. Okay, then next protective, and the last one, that is regulative functions. Okay, productive functions. Why productive? Because it provides us so many resources. Yes, so that's why, for example, timber, that wood that we get from the forest product, these are the forest product. So it provides some raw materials like wood to the paper industries. Fruits, nuts, these all are the resources that we obtain from the forest. So that's why this is the productive functions. Okay, so it is also has some productive functions. Next, protective functions. Okay, so definitely afforestation dawns, the forest mainly check the soil erosions, it avoids the land degradations, so it also has the protective functions. Forests also provide or cover a number of ecosystems, yes, definitely to grow the wildlife, and it also helps to conserve water. So that's why we also have the protective functions. Okay, and regulative functions. So it checks the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the ecosystem, so it regulates. So that's why the function of forest is categorized under three heads: productive, protective, and regulative. Okay. Next, that is the forest fire. We often heard about the forest fire. Okay, forest fire is similar to wildfire, only like bushfires, grass fires, etc. And these all are the same phenomenons depending on the type of vegetation being burnt. So forest fire, we often heard that, right? Recently that Amazon forest is. So the forest fire differs from the other fires. It is totally different from the other fires by its extensive size, speed, yes, at which it can be spread out from the original sources. So it may cause, fire may be caused by combinations of ignitions, dry wood leaves especially, and oxygens. So forest fire, there are some causes of forest fire. One is natural causes, another is human-made causes. Naturally also for there is causes for the forest, okay, and the two terms it is given in the two terms, that is natural fires and the human made, okay. So many forest fires starts from the natural causes only, for example by lightning only, yes, and sometimes by the temperatures, excess temperatures also. So these are the naturally occurred, okay. So these are the naturally causes of the forest fires. And another is also the human made causes, made by the human themselves. For example, that naked flames, smoldering butts of cigarette. So these are some of the negligence of the humans, okay, and which often leads to a forest fire. Now, effect of forest fire, effects, okay. Loss of valuable timbers, definitely we lost the valuable timbers. Loss of biodiversity, yes. Loss of wildlife habitat also. Reduction in the forest cover also. Soil erosion affecting especially its productivity, yes, infertilities. Soil erosions, health problems may lead to many diseases. So these are the effects of the forest fires. Now, there are some measures through which we can control the forest fire also. So forest fire especially can be prevented by educating the peoples, okay, by providing the awareness program, sensitizing them, especially the peoples who are just near this forest area. So by educating them also we can control the forest fire, okay. Next topic is wildlife. These are related to the natural vegetations. We all know that the wildlife, what are wildlife? So domesticated animal species are used by humans for their livelihood, while wildlife consists of those which are not being used for the direct human benefits. So these are those animals which are not used by the humans directly. These animals are called the wildlife, okay. So wildlife in India, we found the types of wildlife in different forest areas that depends on the nature of the forest. For example, especially the Gir forest, G-I-R, Gujarat, okay, that is famous for lion. Gir forest of Gujarat is famous for lions. Mainly in this forest, we found the lions, okay. Another example, in Bengal, especially Sundarban is famous for Royal Bengal tiger, yes. So even the areas, the forest that is also categorized, okay, according to their natures. Next one, that rhinoceros, hippopotamus, these are mainly found in the Assam. Assam is famous for one horn rhinoceros, yes. Odisha coast, that is famous for turtle. And there are so many others areas which are famous for the particular species only, okay. And another examples I want to give you, the elephants that are specially found in Africa, okay. So not only in India, even in the world, the forest or the animals are mainly found according to the nature of the forest. Now, importance of wildlife. Why these animals are important in our life? They played a very vital role in our life. Yes, because they maintain the ecological balance, they maintain the biological processes, okay. So we all know that the ecosystem, we have studied earlier, yes, ecosystem is a interactions of the living organisms. It's a systems that is formed by the interaction of the living organisms. So the wildlife also maintains the ecological balance. So that's why it is very important for our daily life, and it also plays a very important role in pollination process, germination process, seed dispersal process, yes, soil regeneration process. So that's why these animals are important for our daily life, as they are wildlife, okay. Ecosystems. Now what is ecosystem? So it is a relationship, yes, interaction relationship between all the living sources and resident of that particular area, okay. This includes animals, plants, fish, bird, whatever found around here, okay, available around, microorganisms, people and the non-livings, even the non-livings like air, water, soil, etc. These all together form the ecosystems. Next topic is germination. So what is germination? It is a process in which a plant emerges from the seed or spore and begins its growth. You have already studied this term in your science also, I hope so. So germination, it is a process by which the new plant emerges from the seed, okay. Your next term is pollination. So pollination is also a process, okay? It's a process by which pollen, that yellow color pollen, is transferred in the reproductions of plant, okay? Pollination is a process of transformations of the pollen grains. Next topic, that is predations, okay? Predations is the interactions between species in which one species uses the another species. So this is a system, this is a process in which the one type of species use the another for their benefit. That is, that system, that process is called the predations. Okay, so don't be confused about these three terms. Germination is a process through which a plant, new plant, emerges. Pollinations, transformations of pollen grains, and predations, in which the species, one category of species, used another species. Now, some reasons for the loss of natural vegetations and wildlife. Number one reasons, that is human interferences, like constructions, definitely yes, humans, these are the main important, humans are the major factors for the reasons of the loss of natural vegetations, even for the destroying of forest areas, okay? So human interference, okay, like constructions that expanding into forest, want of space, more space, so that also cause the loss of wildlife. Deforestation is another major factors that leads to the extensive loss of vegetations and wildlife. It destroyed the wildlife, okay? So this is another one. It destroyed their life only, their lifestyles only. So that's mainly deforestations, it disturb the habitats, okay, their natural habitats only. Next one, soil erosion. Yes, soil erosion also caused the loss of vegetations. Forest fire, that is widely affected mainly, okay, during the period of, especially during summer seasons, dry seasons, yeah, these are the negligency somehow by the peoples themselves or by the nature. So forest fire, which bring widespread damage to the wildlife. Natural disaster, natural calamities like tsunamis, landslides, yes, soil erosions by landslide. So these are also the another factors for the loss of natural vegetations and the wildlife. Natural disasters, so like this tsunamis, landslides, yes, soil erosions by landslides, these are also the major reasons for the loss of wildlife. Another, poaching of wildlife, this is another important factors for the loss of wildlife. Now there are some restricted areas just to protect, conserve our wildlife, okay? These are the methods adopted by the government, okay? And these restricted areas, these are national parks, okay, sanctuaries, specialties, and biosphere reserves. Now what are national parks? National parks, these are the strictly reserved for conservations of wildlife, includes both flora and fauna. So these are the restrictive reserved areas for the wildlife, okay? And sanctuaries, wildlife sanctuaries, this gives the protection of fauna only, okay? That sanctuary, wildlife is written there. So wildlife sanctuary is mainly for the protections of fauna only. And according to that rules, that laws passed by the government of India, there's a act, okay, Wildlife Sanctuary Protection Act. So according to act, killing of the animal is totally prohibited. And the last one, that is biosphere reserves, that is also another planned of government. These are special category of protected areas of land and coastal environment wherein peoples are an integral component of the system. We know what is biosphere. So biosphere is to reserve the biosphere, to protect the biosphere, is another measures taken by the government to protect natural vegetations as well as wildlife vegetation. And the last point is efforts. Some efforts, measures taken by the governments or by the common peoples, okay, to conserve natural vegetations as well as wildlife. Conservations and protections of national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves. It is not only the duty of the government, it is our responsibility as a citizen of India to conserve such reserved areas like national parks, sanctuaries, and the biosphere reserves. Awareness program, definitely awareness program through social forestries, yes. So this should be done. Next, encouraging school students mainly, that also another way to conserve the natural vegetations, okay, to provide educations, these are the things. Next, many countries have made stringent laws and declared certain traits related to skin, hide, snails and teeth of the wild animals illegal. So laws has been already passed to kill the animals or to sell such type of animal skins, hides. This is totally illegal and punishable. And the last one, to increase the number of rare species by breeding them under the special care of scientists. So one must be aware about these things. There is a way, there is a process, and there is a law by the government that especially it is done under the very strict constructions or the very strict rules, regulations under certain concerned persons. So they increase the number of rare species by the process of breeding. So these are some efforts that not only the government, we even can do to conserve our natural vegetations. Okay, so these are all about natural vegetations and wildlife resources. Let's do the exercise of the same chapter. So first question, that is choose the correct option. Okay, so number one, your answers will be number two, tundra regions. Number two, that is number three, deciduous. Okay, number three, number two, number four again, five, that is four, and six again, number three. Next, fill in the blanks. First one, it is desert. Second one, 140. Third one, 1/3. Fourth, germination. Fifth, pollen. Sixth, wildlife. Seventh, paper. Eight, oils. And nine, tundra. Now next one, true false. Okay, first one is false, second one true, third one true, fourth false, five again false, number six false, number seven false, number eight false, number nine true, number 10 true. Next one, match the following. Okay, 1 with 3, 2, 4, 3, 1, 4 with 2, 5, 6, and 6 with 5. Now the short answers, okay? First question, what kind of forest are found in equatorial regions? Evergreen forests are found in equatorial region. Number 2, why do evergreen forests always appear green? They do not shed their leaves simultaneously in any season during the year. So hence, they always appear green. Number 3, write down 3 effects of the forest fire. So number 1, effects, loss of valuable timber resources. Number 2, loss of wildlife habitat. Number 3, reductions in forest fire. Number 4, suggest 2 measures by which we can control forest fire. Number 1, it can be controlled by educating the people. It can be controlled by obeying the laws. Next one, number 5, what is pollination? Pollination is a process by which pollen is transferred in the reproduction of plants, thereby enabling productions of seeds. Number 6, what is ecosystem? Ecosystem can be defined as a complex relationship between all the living resources. Number 7, why have we built wildlife sanctuaries? Wildlife sanctuaries gives protections to fauna only. Killing of any animal is prohibited. Okay, these are the short answer. Now the long answer, your first question's answer is here. Name and explain the 4 types of vegetations. So the first one is evergreen forests are found in equatorial regions, Central America, Amazon basin, etc. They do not shed their leaves simultaneously. Next one is deciduous forest. They shed their leaves in a particular seasons of the year. They look almost barren. Next one, tropical forest are closed canopy forests growing in areas where rainfall is more than 200 centimeter, and they are found in Chile, South Africa and South America. The last one, that is the temperate forests, which are mainly found in the moderate climatic regions like Eastern Asia and Eastern USA. Question number two, write down the protective functions of the forest. Forest check soil erosions and land degradations. Forests provide cover to a number of ecosystems for the growth of wildlife. And number three, it helps to conserve water. Question number three, what is forest fire and how is it caused? A forest fire is similar to wildlife, bushfire, grass fire, etc. It is an uncontrolled fire in combustible vegetation that occur in the countryside. And it could be caused by natural as well as human-made causes. Natural causes, many forest fires start from the natural causes. It may or may not be spread as widely, that depend on the prevailing humidity and temperature. Next is human-made fire. That fire is caused due to the negligence of the people, for example, smoldering butts of the cigarette, etc. Question number four, write down the importance of wildlife. Wildlife plays an essential role in the ecological and biological process that are significant to life. The biosphere functioning is based on an endless interactions amongst animals, plants and microorganisms. Thus, in turn, mountains enhances human life further. Number five, give reasons for the loss of natural vegetation and wildlife. Number one, human interferences like construction activities and expanding into forests for want of space and setting up industries. Number two, soil erosion causes loss to vegetation and the wildlife. Number three, poaching of animals, especially the wild animals, for collections and illegal trades of hides, skins, nails, teeth, horns, etc. Forest fires bring widespread damage. Question number six, write down the ways by which we can conserve wildlife. Through awareness programs amongst communities at rural and urban level, we can conserve wildlife. Number B, encouraging school children to go for bird watching and their visits to nature camp. Number C, many countries have made stringent laws and declared traits related to animal as illegal and punishable. Number D, conservations and protections of national parks, sanctuaries and biosphere reserves, we can protect wildlife. So these are the questions, long questions, short questions. Okay, you have to do this by yourself. Okay, this is for your homeworks. This activity you can do it in your book itself. Okay, so you can check the answers from our school website also. Thank you.